The National RV Training Academy just launched their solar program, and just to show you what they can do, we're going to put our money where our mouth is. We're going to do a complete battery and solar install on a high-profile YouTuber. That's right, we got none other than JD from Big Truck Big RV.
So the student we chose is Chris Killeen. He actually went through our one-week training. He's also a certified inspector with the NRVTA. Chris, glad to have you on board.
Great to be here. Appreciate it.
So what's in a solar system? You have some sort of solar panels, some selection of batteries, and of course, some selection of inverters. Stick with us throughout this video and you'll learn more about each one of them. What we're installing is the GoPower 570 watt solar system. It's 570 watts worth of solar power. It's their IC series 3000, along with their solar controller. It's a full setup. We're gonna put it in that rig right over there.
Yeah. It's that one right there.
Oh. First things first, we've got two batteries, an inverter, and an EMS that we have to find a place to put. We've got a storage space, and behind that storage space is a divider wall. So we're gonna see if we can get behind that divider wall.
If he does turn on his generator, he's on leg one, he can boost that another 3,000. Yeah. So lower the load on his generator. Okay, but we just gotta find a place up here for us to add that EMS. Let's look back here. It may be on the outside. We just shore this up.
You mean like outside here?
Yeah.
So got a chance to actually look at the rig, and what we noticed inside the storage bay is there's a divider wall here, and there's just enough space for us to put the entire system behind the wall. So that's what we'll do.
What do you think? I mean, I don't know that it can take the wall back any further.
Well, he moved it.
Yeah. So is there more?
Just, we could just move the wall back out, put the batteries behind the wall.
Ah. All right, so there's three types of batteries, but for time's sake, I'm only going to talk about two. Matter of fact, I'm only going to mention two and talk about one. Now, between the two that we have our standard lead acid batteries, and now we have what we call lithium. And just for time's sake, again, what we're going to say is that lithium is a better selection of batteries when we're talking about using it in a whole house application, turning on our air conditioners, everything else. These lithium batteries, the chemistry that they have, they're more of a sprinter, where our lead acid batteries, deep cycle batteries, are more of a jogger. So let's think about that. If you can sprint hard and fast and get out the gates, huge amount of load. Well, that's what we're doing with our air conditioners. And so that's what we have with the lithium batteries. Now, when we're looking at lithium batteries, what we're really looking for is how much storage do they have? How much storage do they have? And that storage is actually quantified in amp hours. And that lets us know how long can we run a particular item or a selection of items for a given amount of time. These batteries with GoPower, they're actually 250 amp hours each for a total of 500 amp hours. Now that's done at 12 volts. If we were to go ahead and increase that to 120 volts, because of course we have our inverter, we got roughly around 50 amp hours. That allows us to, let's just simply take, say, an air conditioner that runs off of 20 amps. We can run that air conditioner for a good 2.5, maybe 3 hours without cycling on and off. And that determines how big of a battery stack we actually want based on our usage. Now that you know about batteries and where we're going to place them, let's start making some cables.
Yeah, don't video this. People are going to be like, why are you using a straight razor? Why is the instructor using the wrong tool?
Meet me, Todd Henson, Master Instructor of the National RV Training Academy. The National RV Training Academy is the largest hands-on, certified and licensed RV training facility in Texas. Our top-notch instructors train individuals from fundamentals all the way to certified technicians and special classes for people who want to install solar systems or work on generators.
We got till tomorrow to do this. It's probably lunchtime, but we're just now getting started. We have a plan. It's a good solid plan, so no issues yet. We still have to get up top and see if we can make a second drop. And from there, there may be some issues. So I'll cross our fingers and hope for the best.
I don't know.
There'll have to be a long day here. And that's what we want.
Your battery terminal, so you can go on and
Yeah, on the bottom. 400 block.
The nice thing about GoPower is they provide solar kits. Guys, let me tell you, it is difficult trying to put together everything if you don't have a kit. And I think that's the reason why a lot of people have shied away from building their own solar system. GoPower has found that need and decided to go ahead and do something about it. So they provide kits for you to buy where you get nearly almost everything that you need in order to put this onto your rig. So in their kits, they provide you with mostly everything for you to set up. It's kind of hard to actually get you everything that you need because each roof may be a little bit different. You may need a little bit more cable, maybe a little bit less. And if it's less, we can just simply cut it. So they give you most everything that you need. I still need an installer to go ahead and install that, but at least you can buy the kit and be assured that you have your 95% there.
This is going to the actual breaker box.
Right, so that...
From the output of
From the output
inverter.
Of there, yes. Okay, oh, okay, I see what you're saying. That's the that's AC
gonna,
out.
Yeah, it wasn't going to be long enough there, so basically flipping it. Because there was plenty of extra slack from the ATS.
And are we going to be able to stay on that floor, or do we need to go over to the tank just a bit?
To the tank.
Well, I was looking, I had one drop, and I set this down, and it just caught the edge. You know what? I'm just going to buy another kit, because it'll be easier than resorting this.
All right, so now we're moving right along. We've actually got everything wired inside of here, minus the battery so far. The inverter is actually wired in, so it's receiving the power coming from the transfer switch into it, and then out of it into the actual power distribution box. And then we've also added the surge guard, surge protector, and that's wiring from the shore power in as well into the ATS.
Inverters come in different shapes and sizes. Typically, we look at the wattage output, what those inverters can actually produce when we purchase those. A consideration that we have with inverters is what else can they do? Some of these inverters, like the IC3000, also offer what we call a pass-through. What this means is if we're plugged into shore power, 120 volt shore power, that 120 volts can pass right through the inverter, and as long as our load does not exceed what we're getting from the pedestal, then the inverter doesn't even have to turn on. If we have limited power with that pass-through, a great thing about the IC3000, it's also a hybrid, which means it will actually help out with the 120 volts that we're getting from shore power. So let's say you're at a house, let's say you are mooch docking and all you have is 15 amps coming in from that house. Your load that you're looking for is roughly maybe 20. You want to turn on your air conditioner. These hybrid pass-through inverters will take that 15 amps from the house, it will match the sine wave, and it'll actually add the extra 5-6 amps that it needs from the batteries as an inverted power to go ahead and run your air conditioning. So these are great inverters to have. One consideration that you want if you're looking at having a whole house is to make sure that your inverter is not only a pass-through, but also has a hybrid power assist function.
Into day one, we got the 120 volt done. Getting into the 12 volt tomorrow. We got one more day to do this. Well, gonna get the two batteries, gotta line them up. These are awfully big. I mean, twice the length of a regular battery, which makes sense, because of 250 amp hour. But trying to get him as much space back as possible. And he'd like to be able to take the wall down. The problem is, we gotta give him a battery disconnect. Can't be behind the wall. May have to run it up. Put it up top, up under here.
This is what we have to do this morning. We finished up everything yesterday that's 120 volts. So today we're attacking 12 volts. That means we're gonna get the solar panels up. We're looking to find out where we're gonna put our drop. We're taking kind of an inventory of what we have, and we have limited cable and some limited boxes to actually put these in. So we're gonna have to plan this, and hopefully, you know, cross our fingers we can get it done. But once we get that drop, then we're gonna start hooking up the solar controller, start hooking up the batteries, get our 12 volt all set. Once we get our 12 volt set, we can start running power over to the inverter. start running through the process, getting everything set up. Now with solar panels, we're really looking at how much footprint do we have up on top of the roof. And so a lot of times all we simply do is just get up there to figure out where we can place these. But here's the consideration. We have a lot of things, such as our air conditioners that actually stick up above the roof. And if you'll look, you'll see that the sun strike actually changes throughout the day and it would cast shadows. So as an installer, the one thing that you really want to look at is not putting any type of solar panels next to air conditioners where there may be a shadow thrown on there, because that actually affects the performance and could knock out any type of solar charging you're getting from your solar panels. So when we're looking at how many panels that you need, this is kind of a very often asked question, and there's no one right answer. So when we're looking at solar panels actually do two things for us. If we're using a load during the time of the sun strike, the solar panels work with the battery in order to create that 120 volts. But typically what we want to do is have enough solar panels to recharge those batteries to get us through the night. You see, because we have a lot of wall warts, we got fans, we have clocks, we may have little space heaters on while we're sleeping. And while we're sleeping, we have no solar power, we can't use generators at night, so we need to make sure that our batteries are topped off to get us through to that next morning.
We've got a place where we think our drop is, and so hopefully we can do this here, and hopefully we have enough cable, because this, you know, PV cable is not something you just run to the store and go get. So let's see what we can do. Are you ready to go ahead and drop it in?
I'm ready.
All right, that's it, we got.
All right.
So I'm in the hole. Hey, pull it up for a second. All right, good, stop. Cable's good. That's annoying. All right. Taping up on this fish, and we're going to pull up the cable that's going to go from our solar controller up into our combiner box up top. Connect this to our PV cable. The first time was a failure. We're trying to do two at once. I think we have the clearance, but clearly I was wrong the first time. I can hear it. All right, keep pushing. Oh, look, there it is. Yeah. Hey, Chris, what's going on? Well, all right, I got it unstuck. You want to try it again? Are you clear? All right, I think we can do this. Awesome. Well, that was a sigh of relief. Now we gotta figure out whether our combiner box will work for us. So yeah, we're gonna go 50. You might feel a little tingle.
So now I got them wired in series. So to check them, based on 22 volts each, I should get 44 volts.
my positive. Hey, look at
you. Still not tall enough to do this.
All right, so go ahead and give you an update. We actually got our solar panels up. They're actually drilled in and actually got all those sealed up. We actually have our drop down, our what we call our combiner box. It's all set up. We're just not connected. We're going to get down here and we're going to start working on combining that with the 12 volt. Go ahead and check all the connections. Now, it's always best to have someone else come in behind you, kind of check your connections and make sure that they're everything's tight. Sometimes you tend to find something that may be loose. So I want to make sure that I can't pull anything off. I don't want them moving at all. Right there. Look. Yeah, some high amperage. Man, that would be some heat. That's the worst thing we can do. We need to tighten that up.
All right, so let's go ahead and talk about the importance of checking all of our connections. One of the biggest problems we have in the RV industry when it comes to electrical is loose connections. When we have loose connections, we're creating heat. We have those electrons running through, and if there's any type of gap, they'll have to arc over, which causes heat. So what the best thing to do is always check your connections, make sure you got the proper torque. So if this is something you're taking on, it's always best to have someone else come behind you and check your own connections and make sure that they're tight.
Challenge accepted, challenge completed. We're able to go ahead and get this done in 2 days. So we've got our 12 volt set up. We're actually going ahead and key it in now. Actually, when we turned it on, we already had an instant amp draw. It's coming over from the refrigerator. We still have the 12 volt system it came with, as well as the 1000 watt inverter that was going over to the refrigerator. Might as well just go ahead and keep that there. But we set up something a little bit different, so we have two systems all set up, and it's going fine. So, good job, Chris. Good job, everybody. I know you're watching, so great job for watching. All this right here. That's about it. That's all I got. What you want? Wait, don't go anywhere. All right, so if you like what you saw here and you're thinking about maybe installing your own system or even maybe considering becoming an installer or maybe a certified technician, go over to the National RV Training Academy. You can go over to NRVTA.com and go ahead and get signed up, and I'll see you in class.